Hi guys, welcome to this new series for Arduino. Arduino is an open source electronic prototyping platform. You can use it for simple electronic project with LEDs, LCDs, digital and analog sensors, to advanced project with Internet of Things applications, 3D printing, advanced communication protocols, and many more. We're gonna go through all that in this tutorial series. It's gonna be a lot of fun. So whether you're a beginner, you've never used Arduino platform before, don't have to worry. The first few is gonna be very simple. Gonna learn the basics of Arduino, how to install the software, making simple electronic circuits like blinking an LED, reading a push button and stuff like that. And then we're gonna tackle the more complicated later on. So let's get started. Here are a few things you're gonna need to run through this tutorial. The first thing we're gonna need is the actual Arduino board. You're gonna need a USB cable so that you can program the Arduino. This cable will also power the Arduino board, drawing power from your PC. You're gonna need also a breadboard. This is very useful for prototyping electronic circuit. You're gonna need a couple of LEDs, resistors, push button, an LCD screen. You might want a DC motor or servo motor, or we might even use a stepper motor and some other devices as we're gonna progress through with our tutorials. There are different types of Arduino board, and as all Arduino boards are completely open source, so there are many variations that you can find on the market. You don't have to get an Arduino branded Arduino board. You can also build your own Arduino board, as the circuit diagram is freely available as an open source. The most popular is the Arduino Uno. The Arduino Uno is a cheap paste. You can get one at about $30 depending on where you live. This is the simplest to start with. It's based on the 8 Mega 328 microcontroller. This 8 Mega 328 microcontroller it's got 38 kilobytes of flash memory for storing the program, 2 kilobytes of SRAM and 1 kilobyte of EEPROM. The USB plug is used to power the board from your computer USB port if an external power supply is not used, and also to transfer the program code from your computer into the Arduino. The external power supply can come either from AC to DC adapter or battery. The adapter can be connected by plugging a 2.1 mm center positive plug into the board power jack. The lead from a battery can be inserted in the ground pins and the voltage in header of the power connector. The board can operate on an external supply from 6 to 20 volt. If supplied with less than 7 volt, however, the 5 volt pin may supply less than 5 volt and the board may be unstable. If using more than 12 volt, the voltage regulator may overheat and damage the board, so the recommended range is 7 to 12 volt. These are the digital input-output pins. These pins can be either input or output pins. Input are used to read information from sensors, while output pins are used to control actuators. You'll specify the directions, whether it's going to be an input or output, in the sketch. By the way, the programming code of Arduino is called a sketch. Digital input can only read one or two values, and digital output can only output one or two values, either high or low. This is the serial output, and this is the serial input pin. This is the analog reference pin, and this is a digital ground. This is the reset button, and this is an in-circuit serial programmer. And these are the analog pins. The analog pins are used for reading voltage measurements from analog sensors, such as temperature sensors, in contrast to digital input, which can only have two values, either high or low. Analog input can measure 1024 different levels of voltage. We've got also the analog output pins. These are basically pin 3, pin 5, pin 6, pin 9, pin 10, and pin 11. These are actually six of the digital pins that can perform a third function. They can provide analog output. As with digital input output pin, you specify what the pin should do in your sketch. This is the Arduino Mega 2560. It is designed for more complex project. It got 54 digital input output pin, 16 analog input, and a large space for your sketch. This gives your project plenty of room and opportunities. This is the Arduino Uno. The Arduino Uno is the perfect board to use when designing connected devices and more in general Internet of Things project. The board has built-in Ethernet and Wi-Fi support, a USB port, a micro SD slot, 20 digital input-output pin, of which 7 can be used as power width modulation output and 12 as analog input, and micro USB connection. The board uses also a 16 MHz crystal oscillator. It's got in-circuit serial programmer header and 3 reset buttons. There are also some Arduino shields that you can use. An Arduino shield is basically a board that can be plugged on top of the Arduino PC board to extend its capability. This is an Arduino GSM shield. This shield allows the Arduino board to connect to the internet to send and receive SMS and make voice calls using the GSM library. This is how you can plug the Arduino shield on top of the Arduino board. This is a GSM shield plugged on top of the Arduino board. There are plenty of other shields. This is the Arduino Ethernet shield. This shield allows the Arduino board to connect to the internet. It has a standard RJ45 connector with an integrated line transformer and power over Ethernet enabled. This is the Arduino Moto shield. This shield is based on the L2980, which is a dual full bridge driver designed to drive inductive load such as relays, solenoid, DC and stepping motors. It lets you drive two DC motors with your Arduino board, controlling the speed and direction of each one independently. You can also measure each motor current absorptions, among other features. And basically, that's the Arduino in a nutshell. Thank you guys for watching this tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive more tutorials in the future. And if you have a comment on this video, you are welcome to leave a comment on the video or on our website. And I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Thank you.